Hi guys, David and David here from payitforward.com, and in this video we're going to explain what to do when your iPhone won't connect to iTunes on your PC or your Mac.
Mm-hmm. So the first thing we're going to do is troubleshoot the universal issues that affect iPhones on both PCs and Macs. Then we're going to take a look at PC issues, then we're going to take a look at Mac issues. So let's dive in. The first troubleshooting step we have is to check
your lightning cable. Yep, going right here. This is actually a pretty brand new cable, so it looks pretty
great. It's going to look great. If yours doesn't look like this, take a look at both ends, make sure they're not frayed. Also, try a different lightning cable.
Sure.
Sometimes that fixes the problem. Seems simple. Next step?
USB port, check that. Try multiple USB ports.
Right. A lot of the times there could be some gunk in a USB port, and just try a different one.
Yep.
Sometimes that'll fix the problem too. Simple fixes so far.
Yep.
Next up,
restart your iPhone could be a software crash.
Mm-hmm. Simple software crashes on iPhones can interfere with the process. How do we do it?
Press and hold the power button, iPhone 8 and earlier, iPhone 10, side button, and volume down button.
Mm-hmm. And then you'll slide the power off, just turn it off, turn it back on. Sometimes that fixes the problem.
Sure.
Next step is to update your iPhone software.
Sure.
How do we do it?
Open the settings app, tap general, tap software update. If a software update's available, it'll say download and install. I updated my software yesterday, so it says your software is up to date.
Mm-hmm. So the first time you connect an iPhone to a computer, a little pop-up appears that asks if you want to trust this computer. And you have the option to click trust or don't trust. If you click don't trust the first time, your iPhone won't connect to that computer forever. So there is a way to reset this setting if you have clicked don't trust in the past. How do we do it?
So let's go back to the settings app, go back to the main page in the settings app, scroll down to general, scroll down to reset, and you're going to tap reset location and privacy. Enter your passcode, confirm, reset, and iPhone turn off, turn back on, and your location and privacy settings will be reset.
So our final universal tip here to fix this problem is to disable software that may be interfering with your iPhone's connection to your computer. Usually this is antivirus software that gets in the way and tries to scan the device when you first plug it in. A lot of times that just breaks the whole process.
Right.
So if you have Norton installed, I'm gonna take a look at this PC over here, put on my PC hat. Down here in the bottom right-hand corner, a lot of the times when you plug in an iPhone, you'll see a little pop-up appear. If it does, try turning off that software.
And we'll link to Apple's article on this topic below in the description.
Mm-hmm. So now we're going to move on to the PC fixes.
Sure.
The first step is simply to update iTunes on your computer. And how do we do that? In the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, click the Windows button. On other versions of Windows, it might be a little bit different. And just find Apple Software Update. So I'm going to go to All Programs, and I'm going to choose Apple Software Update here at the top. If an update is available, your computer will search for it, and then you can choose to install it. A lot of the times, that fixes the problem. So there's no update available for me, so I'm just going to click quit right now. The next step is to update the device driver on your computer, or just make sure that it's working properly. A device driver allows your iPhone to communicate with your computer properly. Now, there are a lot of different ways to get into Device Manager, which is where we need to go, but I'm going to show you a way that will probably work for every version of Windows, and it's a little bit of a shortcut. On your keyboard, there's a Windows key. So what we're going to do is we're going to hold that key and tap R. So Windows R. This comes up with a little run prompt. What we're going to type in here is devmgmt.msc, and we're going to hit OK. This should open Device Manager on your computer. Take a look down here under Universal Serial Bus Controllers. Just click that little triangle to open this up. You should see Apple Mobile Device USB driver here. Double-click on that to open it, and then click driver here at the top. Next, click update driver, and tap search automatically for updated driver software. Windows will search the internet and see if there's an update. If there is, choose to install it, and that may fix this problem. After you do this, you may have to unplug your iPhone from your computer and plug it back in. Just try that. Click close here and close Device Manager. And before we move on to the next step, I just want to reiterate the importance of checking for antivirus software on a PC. A lot of the time that can interfere with this. So if you want to connect to your iPhone, sometimes you could just disable it for like 30 minutes, turn it back on, problem solved. If that doesn't work, we need to uninstall and reinstall iTunes on your computer. I'm going to show you a quick way to add and remove programs on your Windows computer. Again, type Windows key R to open the run prompt. And then type in control appwiz.cpl and tap enter. This will open the programs and features or add and remove programs, whatever it's called on your version of Windows. And there are a few things that we can uninstall and then reinstall here. Pretty much anything Apple you can get rid of and then reinstall it. So I would uninstall Apple mobile device support. Just tap on it, click uninstall, go through that process. Scroll down to iTunes. Tap on this, click uninstall, go through the process. After you do it, reboot your computer. Then go to Apple's website or just open up Google and do a Google search for download iTunes. Google does a great job of suggesting the right link here. Just tap go to download, go through the process, and you can reinstall iTunes like this. If that doesn't work, our final PC troubleshooting step is to update Windows. Again, we're going to open the run prompt by typing Windows key R, and then type in wuapp.exe to open the Windows Update app. Just check for updates in here. I have updates disabled on my computer just because I have an older Windows PC that I'm running and it slows things down. But if iTunes isn't working for you, a lot of times this will fix the problem. So that wraps it up for our PC
version. So that's what to do when your iPhone won't connect to iTunes on PC. You did a great job of explaining that. I don't have any Windows experience, so you really took that one away.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Macs.
So on Macs, the process is pretty similar. We just need to start by updating iTunes. Mm-hmm. So in the Apple menu, in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, just click on that, and then click on App Store. When the App Store opens, come on over here to Updates and click on that. And you can see on my computer that iTunes is up to date, but an easy way to update your Mac is just to click Update All and go through the process. A lot of times that fixes the problem. Reboot your Mac, try it again, might work.
So if an iTunes update isn't available, we can also check the OS on your Mac.
Mm-hmm. You might see a software update for your entire Mac operating system in here too. If you see it, do it. So our next troubleshooting step is to make sure that your Mac recognizes that your iPhone is plugged in. Now to check if your iPhone is recognized by your Mac, click the Apple menu in the upper left-hand corner of the screen and click on About This Mac. Then click System Report. On the left-hand side, scroll down to USB. And then you'll see USB 3.0 bus or other USB devices, and you can see iPhone is listed here. So my Mac is correctly recognizing my iPhone. If your Mac isn't recognizing your iPhone, try a different USB port, as we mentioned in the beginning of this
different cable.
Yeah. Restart your Mac. If it's still not working, our final Mac troubleshooting step is to reset the lockdown folder.
Yeah.
Your Mac.
It's a bit of a tricky step. We'll link to our full guide on resetting the lockdown folder in a card up above and the description section below.
Mm-hmm. So that pretty much wraps up our video about how to troubleshoot issues with iTunes connecting to your iPhone on PC and Mac. If you continue to have problems, the first thing I would do is take the iPhone, go to a friend's house and plug it into their computer. If their computer recognizes your friend's iPhone and not yours, there could be a problem with the iPhone itself. Mm-hmm. In that case, go to the Apple Store. But let's say your iPhone is recognized on your friend's computer, then we know that it works with computers. It's an issue with your computer. If you have a Mac, definitely take your iPhone and your Mac into the Apple Store. They'll take a look at it. Most likely, especially if other USB devices work, like printers, it's an issue with the drivers or the software, and the Apple Store generally will fix software issues for free. That's a good way to go. If you have a PC, you can try to take it into the Apple Store, but when I was there, we would sort of give people a funny look, I don't know what to do with this. It's a PC. What's that? You buy a Mac. Would you like to buy a Mac? We have Macs here for sale.
Right.
So if you don't want to buy a new Mac, I would recommend calling your PC support. Usually it's a software issue on PC as well.
Yep. So that's what to do when your iPhone won't connect to iTunes on PC and Mac. Thank you guys for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if it helped you out. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click that notifications bell to get immediately alerted when we upload a new video.